Hey everyone, it's Marie and welcome back to my channel at Marie Nicole Designs. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and let's get started. So today I'm playing with the Tonic Studios Stamp Club for the month of June. You can see this gorgeous stamp set here. It's sunflowers and bees and ladybugs with some really fun sentiments. Lots of great images there for coloring, and there's also a coordinating die set. Now, this die set that comes along with the June Stamp Club has dies that coordinate with these stamps, but there's also dies that stand alone. So I'm going to make two cards today, one showing a stamped card and one showing a card featuring the die cuts that stand alone. And to get started with my stamped card, I'm just loading up my Misti with all of these beautiful images. I thought I'd just stamp them all out at once so that I can color them all and then cut them all out. I'm just kind of arranging them to save as much paper as possible. I'm using Bristol smooth paper today because I'm going to be doing some watercoloring with the Nuvo Aqua Flow pens, I think that's what they're called, which are a watercolor pen, and I get the best results with the Bristol smooth paper. I'm using Nuvo's hybrid ink. This is the color Acorn Brown. I chose a brown because I'm going for more warm colors with these sunflowers, and I wanted to do brown instead of black. I thought it would just bring the whole card together a little bit better. Sometimes my magnets get in the way of my Misti, so I just had to adjust that so I can go ahead and stamp this down. Now you can see my images aren't perfectly stamped, but since I'm using my Misti, I can go ahead and stamp again and get some good images to color and then die cut. So getting started with my coloring, here's all my images, and like I mentioned, I'm using these Aqua Flow brush pens. These have a brush tip, they're filled with some super concentrated watercolor, and I made a swatch chart of all of the colors that I have. This swatch chart has come in very handy when I'm picking my colors, because although the pens do have a color label on them, sometimes it doesn't quite match up to the color that all comes out of the pen. It's a little bit different when you see it on paper. So the swatch chart is really great if I'm looking for a more orange red versus a more blue red, or a warmer color or a cooler color. It's a great idea to go ahead and swatch those out. So I'm starting to color my images, and the way I like to do this is take my watercolor pens, just add a little bit of color down to where the shadows would be darkest, and then I bring my water brush and just use some clean water to pull that color out to the rest of the image. So I'm starting with a really light color. I'm putting some really light yellow down onto this flower, and then with my water brush, I'm just moving that color around. I am using this brush and just moving the color around, and I'm leaving some white spots on my petals because I want it to look like some highlights. And I'm going to be adding more and more layers of color on here. These watercolor pens are great for layering since they are watercolor, they're transparent and they move. I'm gonna be adding my darker colors in layers. So I start with my lightest color, then I come in with my next darkest color and just get darker and darker to add in those shadows. I think I'm using a sort of yellow ochre type color here, and I'm just putting it where there would be more shadows. Once I have a little bit of that color on, I'm bringing my water brush back in and just moving that color around with some water. You can see how it blends together really well. It's building up those shadows and it's building up layers of color, so it's really adding to the depth of this flower here. Now, I'm not going to show you all of the images being colored. That would just take too long. It took me a good few hours to do this. I broke it up into several sections because I don't have time to just sit down for a full few hours and color. But this had been sitting on my desk and I was just working on it for about a week or so. And then I just got all of them colored, cut out, and ready to add to my card. So like I mentioned, I'm adding more color in here. I've added some yellows, I've added some brown tones, and now I'm coming in with sort of an orangey red. And I thought this red would really work to add more shadows, add a little bit of contrast to all of that yellow on the flower, and I really like how it turned out. So you can go ahead and just play around with the different colors. If you're using new watercolor markers or anything, I would suggest swatching them out because it really does help you get a feel for what the colors look like on paper. And then just have fun coloring and playing around with that pigment. Now, you may know already, but in case you didn't, this project is part of a hop with Tonic Studios to celebrate their June Stamp Club release. So I have a list of links at my blog. You can follow the description box below. I'll take you over to my blog, to my blog post for this project. And there's a link of names at the end of my blog post that you can follow and just hop along to see everybody's projects that have worked with this month's Stamp Club. So I have all of my sunflowers colored and cut out here. I use the coordinating dies, and I'm just showing you that this group of sunflowers, the die just cuts out one side. So you could use that cluster of flowers sort of on the corner of a card, or if you wanted all of them cut out, you could just cut out the other side by just fussy cutting. So I went ahead and I fussy cut out the rest of those flowers because I'm making a few slimline cards and I just wanted to add them to the bottom of my slimline card. Now I've been really enjoying the slimline size lately. It's about 6x3. So if you cut a 6x6 square of cardstock and fold it in half, you have a slimline card. And I'm just going ahead and I'm ink blending the top layer that's going to go on my card base. I'm putting some yellow down. I'm putting some brown over my yellow to kind of give it that more sunflower type feel. And I'm building a background to put my stamped images on top. Now, after I did this brown, I did go back with some more yellow and smoothed it out a bit. Ink blending does take a little bit of time. You want to build up layers and you really want to smooth out those colors if you want a nice, smooth, ink blended background. Now, to continue with my black background, I'm taking some more of these watercolor brush pens and I'm going to flick on some color here. So I'm getting that watercolor flowing and I'm just taking my cap, I'm flicking on some of this color. I chose a darker brown so it will really contrast with that yellow, and I'm kind of trying to keep my splatters in this colored area. I want that upper right corner to stay pretty white and blank so that my color can kind of fade out into that side. And then I'm going to put my flowers and my embellishments over this background. Now, to add a little bit more something to the background, I'm taking some sentiments from the stamp set. I'm inking them up with that acorn brown, stamping them off to the side, and then I'm doing a second generation stamping. So that's going to give me a more faded look with these letters, but it's really going to add to the background and give it something a little bit different and fun. Sort of using these stamps as a background element for the sentiments, and I am going to add a simple sentiment to the front, but I'm not going to do much more than that. So I'm adding my sunflowers to the front of my slimline card here. I put some foam adhesive to pop it up, and you can see I'm going to add it over a sort of greenish color card base. I'll pop up that front panel with some more foam adhesive to get some more height and dimension. And when I finish this card, I put a few gold sequins and I added a few of those bees and I just stamped that hay on the front, and that finished my first card. So my second card is going to be done in a lot of the same style. I have the same type background that you saw me made, but I'm going to add some die cut flowers instead of stamped flowers. Now, like I mentioned, these die cuts that comes, the dies that come with this month's stamp set and stamp club, they coordinate with the stamps, but they can also be used alone. So I'm using that leaf die that coordinates with the leaf stamped images, and I'm cutting out some of those layering pieces to make a layered leaf, and I'm also going to be cutting out lots of different flowers and layering them together as well. So you have lots of options with this stamp and die bundle from Tonic Studios. You can stamp, you can die cut, you can do all the things and make some really gorgeous flowers and cards. Now I'm building up some color here on my die cuts, and I'm cutting these all out of white paper so I can ink blend on top of them and get some coordinating flowers and things. But you can also use these die cuts over colored cardstock so you don't have to ink blend, or you can watercolor over these die cuts. You can do so many things depending on which paper you want to use and how you want to layer them. I just chose to go ahead and ink blend white paper and layer them together. So I've got my background done. I did it much the same way I did my first card, ink blended, splattered. I didn't add any of the sentiments on there because most of it's gonna be covered up with these die cuts. And I also didn't even add a sentiment. I just really loved how these flowers looked on top of the card. And sometimes I'll leave my cards blank so that next, when I want to send a card, I can go ahead and add a sentiment on it quick for the specific occasion that I want to send it for, and I have a custom card ready to go. So I'm just gluing all of these different pieces down. I did add a few sequins to the rest of this card when I was done. You'll see those in the pictures at the end of the video. But that's a look at Tonic Studio's Stamp Club collection bundle for the month of June. So you can get all of these dies, all of these stamps, and you can just have fun cutting, coloring, layering, and making some gorgeous projects. Now, like I mentioned, if you haven't already, please like this video if you feel inspired to. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Comment, share, do all the things. Make sure you head over to my blog to follow the blog hop. There will be some prizes. And check the description box below for a link to all the products that I used in today's video. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.